In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, in the Gospel of today, the Lord is reminding each one of us, give to God what belongs to God, and give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. As citizens of the universe, we are called to serve a country, a nation, 100%. So also serve God, 100%. When there's a conflict, we must take a proper moral standard. And that is what the Lord is trying to tell us. As we come before the Eucharistic table, let us ask the Lord to give us the wisdom that we may be able to discern what is right in the kingdom of God. Lord Jesus, you sustain us with your word of life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, your word is salvation for all who look to you in hope. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your word is justice for all who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone.
Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, grant that we may always confirm our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving gates unbarred. For the sake of Judah and sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by name, giving you a title though you knew me not. I am the Lord, there is no other. There is no God before me. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord. There is no other. The word of the Lord.
Give the Lord glory and honor. 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 Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all you lands. Tell his glory among the nations, among all people his wondrous deeds. Give the Lord glory and honor. Give the Lord glory and honor. Awesome is he beyond all gods, for all the gods of the nations are things of naught, but the Lord made the heavens. Give the Lord glory and honor. Give the Lord glory and honor. Give to the Lord, you families of nations. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory to his name. Bring gifts and enter his courts. Give the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the Church of the Thessalonians in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work in faith and labor of love, and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ, before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah.
the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent the disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are a truthful man and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord. Brothers and sisters in Christ, I know it's such a crucial time for us who are living in America, and especially the American citizens. Lots of talks, lots of publicity, whom to vote. You open the TV, you open the YouTube, wherever you walk, you have lots of placards. And we are so confused. At this situation, the liturgy of today must give you the clarity. Clarity, what you must do. Also, it is a time, month of October, for the Mission Sunday, the World Mission Day. Also, our archdiocese appealing all the time, "Please give me your financial support." This also must give us a clarity through the liturgy of today. Robert Bolt dramatizes a drama on the Man for All Seasons. It is about St. Thomas More, a beautiful, wonderful saint indeed. Many call him the second John the Baptist. What is speciality about St. Thomas More? He gives us the clarity how we must conduct ourselves in this country and in the country above the heaven. King Henry VIII of England has asked the permission from Pope that can he marry his brother's wife, brother who died, and the church gave the proper document that he can marry the widow of his brother. Later on, he changes his mind. He wanted to marry Catherine, that was his brother's wife, widow. Later on, he changes his mind, he wanted to marry Anne, Why he wanted to marry Anne? Because he wanted to have a male heir for his kingdom. Catherine is wonderful. And now he's asking the church to make that marriage as null and void, that he can marry this woman, Anne. But the church says, no. You have been legally and lawfully married to Catherine. Now you cannot marry while Catherine is alive to Anne. And he, being the king of England, takes the law in his hand. He marries Anne. And he asks all his officials to sign what he has done is right thing. Most of them have signed, but Thomas More. Thomas More is the counselor of King Henry VIII. Not only counselor, but the Lord High Chancellor of England. He stands by the Catholic Church. And he says, what you are doing is wrong. While your present wife is alive, you cannot marry someone else. And Henry VIII imprisoned him. If you don't stand by me, you will be tortured and killed. He says, I will not go against my conscience. Of course, you are my earthly king. My allegiance is to you, 100%. But God first. When just before his death in 1534, he encouraged the people to remain steadfast in faith. His last recorded words were, I die, the king's good servant, but God's first. Today's gospel reminds us of our dual citizenship. We are citizens of the world and citizens of heaven. We have an allegiance and obligation to each. We hope the obligation will never clash, just like in Thomas More, it was never clash. But if they ever do, we must resolve them, just like Thomas More did, without compromise to our God or to our conscience. The first reading of today is something really beautiful. How God makes use of a pagan king for the good of the world. What the reading is talking about, Cyrus the Second. He is the one who, a great founder of the Persian Empire. In the year 539, he has invaded Babylon, destroyed Babylon, took the Palestinians, the Israelites, into captivity. The Babylonians have destroyed Palestine for 50 years. Now, God is making use of the Cyrus, the pagan king, for the good of the people of Israel. He is making use of a pagan for the well-being of the nation. All nations can come to worship the Lord God. He is making use of him, telling the people of Israel, can go back to Jerusalem. Rebuild your temple. Not only that, This Cyrus II is giving all the vessels that has been taken by Nebuchadnezzar, the Babylonian king. Take them back to your temple. Re-establish yourself. Worship Yahweh God. And be faithful to him. And that is what Prophet Isaiah is telling today. He can transform any evil person for the well-being of his kingdom and for the well-being of the people of God. What a mysterious way our God works for our good, you see. The second reading of today, St. Paul is writing to the Thessalonians. The theologians say it may be the first letter was written in 50 AD. St. Paul is trying to tell how good the Thessalonians are. The first three theological virtues are being told in the second reading of today. Faith, hope, and charity. Much more than me, you have been so faithful in your commitment. How you loved each other. How you hoped in God. How you are rooted in your faith. We the people who listen today, who partake in this Holy Eucharist, need to be rooted in this theological virtues. The gospel of today, St. Matthew is trying to drive home to us the wonderful nature of our Savior Jesus Christ. During the time of Roman rule, or Jesus' time, there were three groups, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the Herodians. In the group of Pharisees and Sadducees, the priests and the Sanhedrin, they come together. The two are in this. Now the Pharisees and Sadducees have been trying to trap Jesus. Now they also bring Herodians. Herodians, they are real Israelites. They want the Israelites to be Israel, not under the Romans. But they are double-standard people. Underground, they work for the Romans. Also, they think that they are a faithful Jew. Now, the Pharisees make use of these Herodians to trap Jesus. And during the time of Romans, they had three types of taxes. One is the land tax. Whatever you cultivate, 1/10 you have to give to the Romans of your wheat or your barley or your maize. And they also must give 1/5 of their oil and wine. They also must pay sales tax. Their whatever business they make, 1% of their sales tax. Then above this, they must pay census tax. Who pays census tax? Any citizens just like us? Any citizens, you pay census tax. And the census tax are 1 denarii per person. A man from the age of 14 till the age of 65, every male must pay 1 denarii. And every female from the age of 12 till 65, they must pay 1 denarii. At the time of Romans, there is also in the temple Jerusalem, the Roman coin is never used for worship. That's why the money exchanges were near the temple. Whom Jesus chases away, you have turned my temple into a business marketplace. So in the temple, they pay copper, silver, gold coins. No image of the Roman emperor. Now when these people come to Jesus, the Herodians are trying to trap Jesus. If Jesus says, no, I belong to the Son, I am the Son of God, we must worship God, which is true. But Jesus also tells you must to have your allegiance properly understood. You must lead your life in accordance to the country where you belong. You must also focus on to the country, the heavenly home that has been ultimately designed for you. So he's asking, give me the coin that you have. And they are being trapped. When these Herodians bring a coin, Jesus is not having it. He's the Son of God. He even told Peter, go and catch the fish so that we can pay the tax. Now these people gave the coin of the Roman symbol and the Roman emblems, the inscriptions. Caesar Augustus the Divine is inscribed, and the emperor's image is also printed on one side. Then the Lord is telling them, you give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. This image in the coin belongs to Caesar. And give to God what belongs to God. You and I are created the image of God, book of Genesis. So we belong to God. You give your entire being to God. Isn't so beautiful? When you are born in a country, you belong to that country. You are that citizen. When we are baptized in the baptismal pond, we belong to Jesus Christ our Lord. In baptism, we immerse ourselves into Jesus Christ our Lord. And so, we are created in the image of God. We belong to God. Our final destination is our homeland in heaven. And that's why Thomas More so beautifully says, I die the king's good servant, but God's first. So Jesus is trying to tell each one of us, when you are a citizen of a nation, you also need to be obligated to your country. And when you are a Catholic, you are also obligated to the Heavenly Father who has created you and me in his own image and likeness. The Catechism of the Catholic Church also teaches us, when we are in a country, as a Catholic, we have all the moral obligation towards our country. We need to serve our country. We need to work to uplift our country. And when we pay taxes, we also make sure that our roads, our medical well-being, our fire, or our police officers, and everything in our country is properly handled, properly maintained. So we need to give our full allegiance to our country. Secondly, we also need to give a full cooperation to our church. As St. Paul says in the second reading of today, you have been so faithful in your faith, hope, and charity. And so, we also need to give up ourselves 100% to the Lord. But when our country is not giving us this moral standard according to the Catholic teachings, we can also refute it. We don't have to give that kind of 100% to our country. When it is not protecting the well-being of an individual, well-being or Catholic ethos, we don't have to give that our allegiance to the country. And that is what Thomas More did. And that is what the Lord is trying to teach each one of us. You are hypocrites. You are having double standard. You don't have to be duplicate yourself. Be genuine in what you do. Brothers and sisters in Christ, as we come before the Eucharistic table, this is what we need to learn. First and primarily, we must understand we have the doctrine of dual power. We are citizens of our country, so we need to give ourselves entirely for our country. And we also, the citizens of heaven, we need to give ourselves entirely to God. When a country is not teaching us proper moral standards according to the Catholic teachings, then we don't have to give our allegiance to the country. We are called to stand against it, like Saint Thomas More. Saint Augustine says, when you are the citizens of heaven, you don't give just a 10% or 5%. He's not only speaking about your monetary support to the Catholic Church. He's telling, don't only come on Sunday to the church. You don't bring your child only for baptism to the church. You don't bring your child only to the school to the church. But every aspect of our child, our family, we need to teach them 100% about the Catholic doctrine. We need to give ourselves entirely for the Lord. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we need to check our heart every day of our life. Let us give our 100% to our city, our citizen, our nation, our country. When there is wrong, we need to stand and talk about it. And we need not go with the wind. As Jesus our Lord teaches us, we need to be upright. We are created in the image of God. As St. Thomas Aquinas says, as Thomas More says, may we give first 100% to God and be the faithful servant of Yahweh. As we partake in this Holy Eucharist, may the Lord give us the discernment to know the difference between the right and wrong, and be always dedicated citizens of our country, and be a faithful image of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let's all join together and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day. In accordance with the Scriptures, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Brothers and sisters, as we stand around the Eucharistic table, let us pray for our nation and the world at large, for all the leaders of the universe, and for ourselves, the faithful Catholic, that we may also give ourselves 100% to our Lord.
For the needs of the people of God, the Universal Church, St. Patrick Parish in particular, for all the parishioners of St. Patrick Parish. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, as he continues to lead the Church, may God look graciously upon his every need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our local and national leaders, may Christ show them the way of authentic servant leadership. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who struggle to provide for themselves and their families, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community gathered here today, may Christ's peace reside in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those who have died, may God's light shine upon them as they enter his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, we thank you for the faith that you have instilled in us. May we, gathered here around the Eucharistic table, we pray for our nation and all the world at large. May you give us faithful leaders who can keep up your people according to your teaching, just like Cyrus II, who led the people of Israel. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness.
Shelter me, O God, hide me in the shadow of your wings. You alone are my home. When my foes around me set me
and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his
name. Grant us, Lord, we pray, your sincere respect for your gifts, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundation of the world and have arranged the changings of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Oh,
You are indeed, only your Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy day for these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until
as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity together with Francis the Pope, Eleanor Archbishop, all the assisting bishops, the order of bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, his spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, Saint Patrick, Saint Vincent Pallotti, Saint Thomas More, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us everlasting life.
There is
an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. The Memorare. Remember, most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thine intercession, was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, we fly unto thee, Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee do I come. Before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions. In thy mercy hear and answer me. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from participation in the heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give in this present age, and prepared for the gifts that are eternal, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters.